Hi everybody, name's Matt, social media manager here at Bellusion, and welcome to 2 Minute Tuesdays, where you need 2 minutes of e-commerce advice to bolster your online success. Now, when you're designing your website, it's really easy just to go with what you like, but at the end of the day, you need to please your customers and make sure they can navigate through your website. So to do so, I advise you try something out called user testing. But before you get started, pay close attention because I've got 5 best practices when user testing your website. Now, first and foremost, you'll want to have a specific testing goal in mind. Now, for some background, user testing is all about recruiting strangers or new people to come to your website, giving them a specific task, and then seeing what they do when they get there. So, in other words, you don't want people to navigate all around your website. Instead, give them something like, find this specific product, or tell me where you can find our About Us information. Giving very specific tasks gives a lot more insight into how customers navigate through specific areas of your site, which then leads to new actions. Now, number 2, you'll want to frame the tasks correctly. So once you have that specific goal in mind, you want to make sure that you ask them to do what you want them to do without telling them too much. Now, if that doesn't make sense, think about it. If you say, find our About Us page, all they have to do is go click About Us. So frame it to be more complex. Say, for example, you're looking for something to watch the Super Bowl on. Find that product. Makes a lot different, gives you much better results. Now, third on our list, you'll want to find the right audience to test. Now, it's really important that you're actually testing people who are in the demographic of customers that you're selling to. So, for example, if your main target audience is full of seniors, you wouldn't want to recruit a bunch of teenagers to come test your website because, well, that really wouldn't tell you much. Number 4, you'll want to recruit an adequate sample size. Now, by this, I go back to basic statistics, and that means that you can't just find 1 or 2 people to user test your website and then make big drastic changes about it. Instead, you'll want to find enough people to user test your site so that you find common themes among the findings, and then you have much more accurate information to base your decisions on. And last but definitely not least, make sure that you actually act upon the changes that you found from your user testing. Now, it's quite easy to find this information and nod your head and say, good to know, but unless you actually implement change, you're not going to get anything out of the entire process. Keep these 5 tips in mind when you're conducting any type of user testing for your website. Definitely help you get much more accurate results that you can then implement and hopefully boost conversions. Have any questions? Just leave me a comment in the box below. I'll get right back to you. From me to you, happy selling.